I'm doing this ride because I turned 40 and I thought this would be a nice thing to do. Thought the experience would be really a lot of fun. No, I never have been much of a biker, and I guess I was a little worried about that.
I wonder if her butt will have a permanent imprint of a bicycle seat after this.
All I can say is I'm surprised. This is not the child I raised. She does many things I never thought she could do. Where did I go wrong?
We have nothing to say.
Nothing.
Always been a real trooper, and I remember you from way back, and I know you're going to do wonderful, and you're going to do us proud.
Debbie, I'm really proud of you, honey. I'll tell you, you're precious. You really are.
I started training in April, the day before they had the first meeting. I rode to work and back so that I could say that I started training. First, I just started riding to work a couple days a week, and then maybe I would do a little bit longer ride on the weekend. Then I thought I should probably get up to about 100 miles a week. And then I guess in June, I decided I should do 150 miles a week. So I pushed a little harder, and I went on some longer rides. It's Sunday, July 4th, and me and a couple of the guys are gonna, you know, do a 50, 60, 65 miles today. It's the last big training ride before next Saturday.
Well, it's the last week. If you don't get it together now, it's too late.
Well, we're gonna do it for Anchor House in America.
Ah, Debbie, I remember her well. A good tenant, a nice person. I'm pleased to hear that she did something for charity. I think she had a lovely cat and a dog that was a pain in the ass. However, I wish her well.
If you look at her bike, you'll notice that the tire in back is bigger than the tire in front. I don't know why they do that.
Bye. But you know, the obvious is bad.
body almost.
That guy's chin.
What?
His little chin off the board.
I'm glad we're stopping because I have to go to the bathroom.
The bag stop is a truck where they have water and fruit and snacks, and they have them about every 20-25 miles.
I've been asking for him if anybody's seen him, because I've got his chin.
Has what?
His little chin off.
Made of the mist and took a boat ride on the falls. It was really nice. We got all wet.
They sort of competed with each other, the people that ran the sag stops, to make their stop the one that you would remember.
I'm impressed. I'm simply impressed.
The mornings, you get up real early, usually get up around 5:30 or 6, and most people would just get out there and you'd go out and pump up your tires because apparently you're supposed to pump them every day. And sometimes it would still be kind of dark when you were out there.
Okay, are we off?
Yep.
We're right into the sunrise.
Okay, we start out right?
Yes. Right on Bun Hill Road and right on Bethel.
Now you know the direction change, right?
I'll write it on mine.
Straight at 1.50.
Straight at 1.50.
Okay.
On the first day, we rode 64 miles. On the second day, we rode 56 miles.
Wonderful to room with. Snores a little, but other than that, no complaints. She misses her dog very much.
She's been riding very well. Yesterday she left me in the dust. I was pushing to keep up with her. Her pace was at least 18 or 20.
My body's holding up very well. I've had no butt pain to speak of. I have had no knee pain, leg pain, none of that. Just my elbows got a little stiff the first day. That's about it. So, I feel like most people say I've trained more than anyone on this trip. On the third day, we had to ride 100 miles. It was not a real hot day. And the first 30 miles we rode through Letchworth State Forest, which was very pretty. It was actually kind of misty there, but there were a lot of hills. A lot of people had a hard time that day. I personally had a hard time after mile 70. I got real, real tired.
It was long, strenuous. I didn't do 100 miles, I did 97. But some gearheads did the extra 2 miles to make the century, they call it. I did a decade. 10 miles, that was good enough for me.
Yesterday I fell in the mud and I lost a water bottle. That's right, that was dramatic. And let me see, what else happened? Somebody got chased by a dog and he ran into a barbed wire fence and he had to get a tetanus shot. And then another woman who's riding, who's a diabetic, she had to go to the hospital yesterday. She didn't eat at the right time or something. And so that's been the two catastrophes.
Here we are at the first stop on day 5, and it's going real well, and I'm going to make it, and I don't know what to say. I feel real good. I feel good. They said yesterday that they thought they'd raise $250,000.
Great ride. Good weather. Hills are still ahead of us, though, but we're going to crank through them.
The final day was very exciting. Started out with a real pretty ride along the river. Then we went to a picnic in Pennington, and everybody congratulated you, and they had all kinds of food and stuff. Then we rode 2x2 in a line with all our matching t-shirts over to Quakerbridge Mall, and they had it real choreographed, and you rode in single file, and they told you when to go in, and then you rode your bike in, and then it was a big celebration, and it was a lot of fun.